final, the K1s is all set to go, so too is Jerry Sinstad.
We've actually had a full start here, so you've missed nothing. We have a beautiful morning at the Han River Regatta course, and the conditions are just about perfect. Barely a breath of breeze.
Ready.
And the starter attempting to get them away at the second attempt. And although it looked as though the Hungarian in lane two might have had a bit of a flyer, the starter this time lets them go. West Germany furthest from the camera in 9, USA in 8, the Soviet Union in 7, New Zealand in 6, the reigning world champion, Czechoslovakia in 5, Australia in 4, German Democratic Republic 3, Hungary in 2, and Sweden in the lane nearest to the camera, lane 1. And already Paul McDonald, the 28-year-old reigning world champion from New Zealand, has established a handy lead for himself. The Hungarian, Zsolt Gyulay, double world champion in K4 1000, is in second place. And here is the great New Zealander, Paul McDonald. We in fact have 6 of the finalists from the last world championships in this race, including all 3 medal winners. McDonald, the current world champion, defending a title won for New Zealand on Lake Casitas by Ian Ferguson, his partner in the K2. Gyulay of Hungary with a small lead over McDonald of New Zealand. They have about 80 metres to go. Here comes the Hungarian, 24-year-old sports instructor from the Honved Club in Budapest. Won his heat, won his semi-final, and is now heading the race over the last 50 metres, coming up to the finish in the first medal race of the canoeing at the Han River Regatta course, and he's going to win with clear water to spare. Hungary first, and it's going to be very tight for second. I think New Zealand were just beaten by the East German Andreas Stahle. It'll be a photograph, no doubt about Gyulay of Hungary being the champion. My guess is that Stahle of East Germany gets the silver and McDonald of New Zealand gets the bronze, but it was very, very tight. McDonald, silver medal, says the caption, but I think we should wait for the photograph before we can be certain. Stahle, the 23-year-old East German, silver medalist at the last World Championships. Now, what will the slow motion show us? Undoubtedly, that Zsolt Gyulay of Hungary has taken the gold, no question about that, but between the blue kayak and the white, well, take your choice. It may be a while before we hear the result of that. My money is still on the East German. But here is the champion, and here we can pay tribute to the Korean broadcasters who are bringing us magnificent slow motion pictures of the finish. You won't get closer to knowing what kayak canoeing is about than in these pictures. There is the elation of an Olympic champion. First gold medal ever for Hungary in this event. They had one silver, introduced to the Olympic program only in 1976. So it's a flat-out sprint over 500 metres, and I think we can expect a number of finishes of that kind where the judges may well have to resort to the photograph before we sort out who gets what. It's nearly half an hour before the men's Canadian canoes final starts, in which Eric Jameson will go for Great Britain. He's our only representative today at the Han River Regatta course. Big weight on his shoulders. Britain have never won a canoeing medal, either in canoes or kayaks. Certainly doubtful whether we have ever had better conditions for these events. Great jubilation among the Hungarians. Time 1:44.73 gave him a second and a half advantage over the East German and the New Zealander. Now those are the times that we are being given here, which tends to confirm that Andreas Stahle was indeed second, but those are unofficial times and we will have to wait, I think, for confirmation by the official photograph. Not the fastest time ever in Olympic canoeing at 1:44. We don't have records because conditions vary so much from day to day, but the fastest before these games was set at Lake Casitas by a Russian, 1:43.43, but we've had faster times than that here, notably by the New Zealander Paul McDonald. This is not about times, it's about medals. And Zsolt Gyulay of Hungary will undoubtedly collect the gold. He proved himself quite clearly the best sprinter here, and there will be no need for photographs to decide his title. The last World Championships, he was nearly 2 seconds behind McDonald when McDonald won the gold. But McDonald now 28, not necessarily a veteran in canoeing terms. His partner in the K2 is 36. But this is a moment for Zsolt Gyulay to savour. McDonald comes to join him and to offer congratulations. This is a sport in which there's a great deal of camaraderie and very little of the infighting and bitterness that characterises some sports. The fact that we had on the water today 6 of the finalists from the last World Championships is an indication of how well these people know each other. There's a circuit around Europe of half a dozen major regattas every summer, and all the familiar faces turn up and they know each other and they know each other's strengths. It's a very friendly, happy sport. Been a few tributes paid here to the Canadian starter. You've seen a few false starts, but it's a sport where, particularly in the 500 meter events, if you don't get away on the gun, the chances are you're not going to win. So everybody is very keyed up, and the first stroke starts virtually as the starter says set, and so sometimes they can beat the gun. But here he's been very strict, and on the whole the competitors approve of that because it does tend to cut out the cheating. These will be anxious moments for Stahle of East Germany and McDonald of New Zealand, waiting to know who has got the silver and who the bronze.
Hello, Blanqui. Blanco Olimpia.
Well, if all our races are as good as this, we I think won't have too many complaints here. Competitors have been delighted with the course. Goes too for the rowers who were here last week. Zsolt Gyulay goes away with the Hungarian officials. He'll have a gold medal to add to the 2 that he won over 1,000 meters in the Hungarian K4 in previous World Championships. Gyulay has been the fastest here this week, and so as he disappears, we now prepare to see how Eric Jameson will do for Britain in the Canadian Canoe 500 metres final, which starts now in just over 15 minutes.
Well, there's a little pause.